This is the Hunter's Lodge. Only members and invited guests are allowed in.
How do I get invited?
You've come all the way from the Savage East, right? You must have come across some of our hunting grounds. Each one has a set of hunting trials. If you pass a trial, you get an award called a half sun. Win three, and I'll let you in. Now off you go.
Well then, hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynut and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. I was just wandering around Meridian for a bit and I found the Hunter's Lodge, who didn't want to bring me in because of course they need those half-suns you can collect when you're doing the Hunter Trials, and I didn't do that yet. So I'm going to do that in between recordings when I have the time, and then we'll get back to this lovely bar, it seems, with that. Is that one of those thunder jaws up there? Might be, but that's very cool. But yeah, alas, not for us. Also, it seems like night has set in, and we're gonna continue our tour of Meridian here. So yeah, we checked up here, so that's where the priests were. So I should be able to go down here again, I suppose, or not.
Preferably with no friends or family.
Yeah, that's the guy we got a quest from already. These guys are praying for some reason. And that just leads back into that center area, so no thank you. So let's continue the loop. Although that seems to be it. I'm gonna have to go back. Give me a second. I'm almost done with my tour, and it seems like I've found... Well, we're back at the entrance. That's probably the most important thing. But we kind of paused everything here because we were following Aaron around. And this guy seems to want our attention. So hello, Ravaged.
You're the one the Vanguard has been crowing about. The Nora who tracks criminals and traitors with her second sight. If only you'd use it to help me. A thief raided my home and took my brother's sword.
Okay, that might be something we can do immediately.
Tell me about the robbery. Don't leave anything out.
It was brazen and professional. They took only the sword, my most valuable possession. The thief went out through the window and scared the shadow off my steward. Otherwise, it would have been a clean getaway.
Okay, it almost sounds like you're in awe of the thief.
Why would someone steal the sword?
It's priceless. Made from the burnished antler of a lance horn, finely inlaid with studded stones all down the...
Okay, I get it.
It's a fancy sword.
That's not even why it's important. The 12th Sun King gave it to my brother for his military service. He was killed in battle during the liberation. I was saving it for my nephew who stranded at Sunfall with the Karja in Shadow.
Okay, and your
nephew... How did your nephew wind up in Sunfall?
Most of the old clergy backed the Mad Sun King. So when he fell, they ran out of fear of retribution. As an honor guard to a venerable priest, my nephew had no choice but to go with them. Now that my brother is gone, my nephew is my heir, so that sword really belongs to him. And after all he's been through, I won't be able to look him in the face if I don't get it back.
Okay, then I'll investigate.
See what I can do about the robbery.
Have a word with my steward if you need to. He saw the thief escape. And listen, all I want is the sword back. Meridian, and my family for that matter, has seen enough strife already. If I can get it back, all is forgiven. No retribution necessary.
Okay then. So he doesn't really want us to kill the thief. So robbing the rich. Sounds like Robin Hood, alright. Talk to the steward optional. Hello, steward. So he's right over here.
You saw the thief make a run for it?
My back was to the wall,
you see. That's actually his name.
Wasn't expecting someone to crawl out the window. He ran past me, dressed in gray, clutching a sword. That's all I saw. By the sun, my heart nearly seized up.
Okay, then that didn't give us much. So that's the window, probably.
Drops of blood bleeding away.
Okay, so he got hurt for some reason. Can I actually enter this house? Okay, that is interesting. I need to investigate a robbery from inside his house without actually going inside of his house. So let's highlight the track and let's see where that leads. So it doesn't really lead anywhere, it seems. Aha! There it goes. It's going through the marketplace. I'm quickly gonna check everybody here on the way as well. Probably has a free sample box, thank you very much. Don't think the weapons will be anything different. Shadow Sharpshot, did I have this? Oh no, I definitely didn't have this already. A Sawtooth Heart, I have that actually. And that's a Shadow Warbow, also something I don't really have yet, so... give me a second. So yeah, I'm gonna definitely buy this. So the Shadow Sharpshot Bow, thank you very much. Equip that in the normal Sharpshot Bow, since it's gonna completely replace that, and that's really, really cool. Just gonna sell a few more things, especially Metal Burn is apparently very valuable for some reason. So I'm just gonna sell a bit more of the Metal Burn, just because I can. There we go. And then there's another merchant over here, and I think he might be willing
what did you want
to sell the vessels,
you're
to buy
an
the vessels.
Which is good, but a Nora, which might be bad. Do you fear the ruins of the old ones like many in your tribe?
No, although some can be dangerous.
Then you may have come across what I seek. In your travels, have you found strange vessels, emblazoned with symbols of the old ones? They consist of a hollow cylinder with a crescent handle affixed at both ends.
That is a very curious way of describing a freaking cup.
I will gladly trade what I have for them.
Okay. Ritual vessels.
What sort of ritual were these vessels made for?
I'm convinced they were used in conjunction with each other in sets. Some people believe they were used for tea ceremonies. Others think they held sacred essences and oils for worship. But I believe they were used for the solemn custom of shaving one's beard. One for water, one for lotion, and so on.
No, the tea ceremony was the closest thing.
A special vessel, majestically applied to the face at each stage of the rite. It must have been breathtaking. But which vessel was used for which?
That is interesting.
I have to know. I have to continue my research.
Are you sure people didn't just drink out of them?
Thank you, Aloy.
Drink? Out of such finely crafted earthenware? Don't be ridiculous.
Okay, simple enough, but more
so
about
you're
you.
Interested in the old ones?
More than interested. I study every ancient artifact I can get my hands on. But years of study have made me too comfortable at my desk. I can't even bear the sun, if the truth be known. I don't know how I'll manage to take a partner. My family presses me for an heir.
Don't look at me.
Oh, no, I'm not looking. In fact, my father already has someone he wants me to wed. She doesn't interest me. I wish I had a brother to carry this burden. I would rather be left to my precious little vessels.
Yeah, clearly. And kind of a bit weird.
Yes. Trade quickly. I have work to do.
Well, okay then. So yeah, I don't have any of the sets yet. I only have two, and they're not even of the same set, which is sad, but I can buy, of course, his maps. There we go. That should help us out in finding everything we need.
I will leave you to the hunt. Be sure to delve into the ruins. Ah.
Thank you.
You're everything
Studious
I'm not.
Hollis.
Strong, brave, active. Come, talk a spell.
So let's follow the trail here.
I'm still on the
and
trail.
And that's why there was blood all over, because we found one of those blood stains already. So it's kind of weird that nobody else noticed.
The thief got cut. The trail ends here. But someone must have seen the thief.
Drink and a bite.
Okay. Did you see anything? Kiadi. Hello,
woman? Did someone run past
woman?
Here, holding a sword?
Sure did. He grabbed some linen off the stand here and took off down the stairs behind you. He was bleeding, so maybe he needed a binding. Blast it! That was expensive cloth. I can't believe I paid for that thief's bandage.
Okay then. Interesting. We talked to you already, so... can we find... he went down the stairs. So the stairs should be around here somewhere, yeah. Over here. Going down?
There's only one way he could have gone. Forward.
Fair enough. There's a lot of people here. Somebody must have noticed him, though.
No sign of the thief. Someone must have seen him go by.
Yeah, probably the woman over here, because talk to a witness. I mean, they're just putting NPCs along the path.
Did you see anyone?
Rokasha.
He would have been holding a sword.
Yeah, almost crashed into me too. He ran down the parapet here and went down the lift. No way he'll catch him now. I didn't see a sword, though.
He wasn't carrying anything.
Not a damn thing. Just ran like his ass was on fire.
The thief must have ditched the
sword. Fair enough.
But where? Maybe
probably.
He had help. That merchant stall would have been a convenient drop-off.
That merchant stall? So before he came over here, probably, yeah. So the merchant stall where he picked up the linen then, that is weird. Does that mean that the woman that was over there just lied to us? Because if it's here, then... okay. Yeah, she's gonna have lied to us probably then.
It looks like the thief got away, but without the sword. I thought maybe he dropped it off somewhere. Like here, for instance?
What? No. I had nothing to do with this.
I guess we'll see when I get the city guard to toss your stall and question your customers.
Hold on. There's more to this. You've got a reputation for shining light in the darkness, so...
Already?
I know you'll
Wow.
listen. You're right. The sword was passed to me, and I passed it on to someone else. It's going to be sold, but not for profit. The shards will go to people in need.
You expect me to believe that?
I can prove it. Meet my friends at the watermill in the lower village. They'll explain everything. If they don't convince you, come right back with the guards. I'm not going anywhere.
It wouldn't matter if you did. I'd find you. But all right. I'll check out the watermill. Okay. Guess I should go to this watermill then to find out what's going on.
Fair enough. So, I guess we'll go there then. I'll see you guys in a second. Oh, so we need to use the elevator over here. This is interesting. So these guys just made gigantic elevators. Because, yeah, this place is actually pretty high up. Holy shitballs. I think I summoned the lift. The elevator. Hello? Oh, God, this thing is slow. I know it's fitting for the technology and the like, but... that just takes a very long time. Holy shit. Okay then, fair enough. Let's get in here and I'll see you guys when we get down. Blam! Jesus Christ, that was a landing. I think I would have broken my ankles in that elevator. There's also a few side quests over here, so I might as well just pick those up while we're at it. So one over there, which is a bit off my route.
My family might still be alive, and you're going to stand here and do nothing?
Adanaman. Lost a dozen patrols beyond the valley. Our orders are clear.
Okay then, no more Ranaman.
Tell me what happened to your family. Maybe I can help.
By the sun, I fear they are all dead by now. I barely escaped alive. Machines. Vicious machines attacked my family's estate. Father sent me to get help.
Okay, what
kind
of machines?
Where did they come from?
A Ravager. By the sun, how it cut down those guards, and a pack of watchers came with it. The Sun King warned us that he could no longer protect freeholds beyond the valley, but Father never saw this coming.
A Ravager? I don't think we've seen any of those yet. Your father's
Tell
estate.
Tell me more about the estate.
My father owns a dozen quarries, and he's put his spoils into the estate. Fine tapestries, custom woodwork, silver fixtures.
But what about the people there?
Of course. Their lives are all that matter. My father and sister, plus a dozen guards and servants. I hope they survived.
You're talking about the people, but you first started off by talking about everything inside of the building. That is discomforting.
I'll see what I can do about the estate.
You will? Oh, thank you. Oh, please,
Be careful. Those machines are deadly.
I do love how almost every one of these guys looks pretty unique. You can really distinguish between every one of those. Let's just pick up the other side quest here as well. And see what we can do about that. Maybe even take the... There's a merchant here as well, but let's just go for the side quest. Although, if I pass the merchant, why not, eh? Thank you for your free sample books, I suppose. Goodbye.
Metalbot here. Good prices, fair prices.
At the Metal what?
Fairest prices for machine parts under the mesa. No tithes to the Sun Court. Not like those greedy snarls upside.
She's not interested in taxes.
No,
I know what
I'm
she's not.
Not
interested in. As I was saying, no better offer for snap-maw lenses. I'd give my oath on it.
By the sun, don't start spitting in your palm. Huntress, I apologize on behalf of my partner. Silent partner.
Not so silent partner.
If the sun would only grant my prayers. Never mind snap-maw lenses, Huntress. There's no market for those. A long leg lens, though, you'd be well rewarded for.
I think we have one, right? I'm standing here.
Hello?
I've told you as many times as the spire is tall, craft and artisanship is who we are.
Craft doesn't win a war or keep the machines from your farms. What you need is good old-fashioned plain...
Oh, yes. Old-fashioned plain hammered work. If ever something glittered, you'd throw it back.
If Karja had built that elevator, they would have stopped at a good-looking shaft.
All those years of delving, and you never found a sense of humor.
Okay, then. Maybe you guys should find a room.
So which,
No market for a snap-maw lens. It's good, strong stuff. You can hammer it into anything.
Where do you think we are? Some trading post with sawdust on the floor? This is Meridian. We have culture.
I know culture. Just the other day, I was watching the hunting trials.
Oh, great sun, lend me the strength of midday.
The sun's baked your head if you think we'll shift long leg lenses at a time like this.
Enough!
Enough!
Thank you.
They're a blunt people, the Nora.
Why do you two even work together if you can't agree on anything?
It's a symbolic gesture.
No tithes to the Sun Court, like I said in the beginning, Renine.
Just tell me which part you want.
A long leg lens.
A snap-maw lens.
Fine.
I think I have both of those, busy. No?
Wait. You drove her off. Snap-maw lens. What do you say?
I drove her off? That's rich. Listen, Huntress. Long leg lens.
Hunters, scroungers, bring in your metal.
Wait, what? I have a long leg lens. I thought I had one of those. So let's just talk to Smiling Renine. I have a long leg lens
to sell.
Huntress, you haven't just brought me metal. You've brought me joy. If I could pay you twice over.
Start buying solid parts instead of baubles and you could afford to.
Don't think beyond your purse, man. There's use in these if you've eyes to see and a heart to feel.
What about a belly to feed, huh?
These guys are awesome.
You've got a surplus you can dig into. Chased by a long
that was a fat
a
joke. Generous reward no, books, so like let's just check out our reward boxes. These parts are nice, by the way. Pretty big parts. Let's check out the boxes. That's nice, thank you. And yeah, okay, basic parts.
Recoiling is you from common sense.
Okay, let's continue with robbing the rich. We're pretty close to the water mill, if I'm not mistaken. At least I thought we were, although the quest marker is pulling me away. Because the water mill is over there, apparently. But it does seem like I can't really cross that directly. Although I could, let's just jump into the water. And let's just swim over there. Exiting settlement. Yeah, right now it's actually more fitting than it was before. And there's a boat and a buttload of whatever the hell. Jesus, there's a lot of medicinal herbs here. I'm just gonna grab everything I can here. On our way to the watermill, although we're actually here. But the marker puts me over there. Oh, Jesus Christ. Thank you. Somebody guarding the place already.
Let's try to get past me. They'll have a fight.
Hello, Kindiv.
I was told to expect you, Aloy. I suppose you want answers. Well, it's not complicated. We collect valuable objects from people who don't need them, sell them for shards, and use the money to help the needy at Sunfall.
Why do you talk so weirdly? I think your voice is a bit crooked.
You mean you steal?
If you want to call it that. From hogs who've had their turn at the trough for generations.
Ravondan seemed like a hog to me.
He stinks just like the rest of them, of wealth and contentment, while people beneath him suffer.
The needy.
Who exactly gets the shards at Sunfall?
Not the bastards in the fortress. We use the shards to make sure the poor in Shadowside get to eat or bandage their wounds. They only went west because they had to. Trust me, I know. My wife was chained up with a bunch of servants and herded with them. They starved to death, still bound together.
So this is kind of personal for you.
I'm sorry.
So am I.
And where's the sword?
Where's the sword now?
Safe. I haven't sold it yet.
So what now?
What do you expect me to do now? Walk away?
I was hoping you'd help us. They say you can track like a stalker. Well, my partner Nassan disappeared near the Branded Shore. He was bound for Sunfall, along with an entire shipment of food. If you found that, you'd be helping a lot of people.
I'll consider it. But only if you return the sword to Ravon.
I knew you were gonna say that. Fine, I'll return the damn blade. Nassan was supposed to meet his contact at an old campfire on the fork near the Branded Shore. Start looking there. But be careful. Lots of machines out there, and lots of Shadow Karja. And not the needy kind, but their tormentors.
Okay then. We're still not done with robbing the rich. Go to the fork in the road, and that's quite a ways off. I actually need to check the map for that. Is that even close to... Holy shit. That is not even remotely where I've been before, because this... That's the other side of the map. I do like how the map is completely filled with icons right now, since we have all those maps. So I swapped to the Fatal Inheritance quest for now, because we're pretty close to the Ranaman's estate. So I'll head in that general direction. And we'll see what happens, right? So see you guys in a second. I just want to let you guys see this, because this is some dreary part of a... Ooh, that's a dead guy. Some dreary part of the jungle. Wait, this entire thing is the estate? Because I went through a few arches over there. This entire place is the estate? Holy shit. And yes, indeed. There are... walkers running around, and then there was a ravager. Weakness fire. Looks like just some sort of solitude. So I just lure that watcher over here. Should be fine, because the ravager is not interested in me at the moment. And I'm just gonna stealth kill this puppy over here. Goodbye. Seems like a standard watcher to me. With a bit of standard materials. And stab this guy. Seems like the Ravager isn't really interested. So I might as well just scan this thing. So it's strong against shock, which is interesting. And then the Ravager cannon is probably pretty weak to tearing. So if I go out of this menu and just go to the hardpoint arrows, which are pretty tearing as it is, maybe I should even put down a few traps. Do I have any shock blast traps? There we go. This guy is looking over here, but
time to prepare.
Holy shit. What does that even do? That looks cool. So now, just two arrows of the hardpoint variety on my bow. And there goes the cannon.
You're not gonna like this.
Oh, there we go. I think it exploded. Now I'm gonna go for burning arrows. Ooh, this thing is aggressive. Ah, damn it. Shouldn't be drinking potions like this. There we go.
I wonder what made the machines attack without warning.
That is Search the Ravager indeed. Metal shards, a Ravager lens, and then standard materials. That is interesting. 10 vulnerable machine kills. There we go. Trophy. And then I shot down its weapon. What the hell is this? Whoa! I can't really kill anything with this now, but. Okay, that's cool. Rain fire down.
No good without the right ammo.
There we go. Yeah, because I can't really kill anything with this anymore. Oh. Workshop key.
Wonder what it unlocks.
Yeah, indeed. You just stole a key from a dead woman. Then there's a sparker. 4 sparker, actually. And then, yeah, one of the traps I put down. Can't really take those back, apparently. So let's just keep that here in the garden. Probably very, very safe. And then the workshop key. Hello? Yes? There's two watchers here, but it appears this guy's dead as well. Might have been the father. But there's clearly somebody still alive over here. But there's a lot of supply boxes in the neighborhood as well, so don't mind if I do first. Let you out of what? Where did you go?
Can you hear me?
Pry open door. That was a weird animation glitch, but there we go.
Hello?
That was even weirder.
Oh, thank you. I didn't really believe anyone was coming for me. I think everyone else is dead.
Daradi. What happened exactly?
Tell me what happened when the machines attacked. There were screams. I came running. The Ravager ripped through the guards like dolls. My father pushed me into the larder. I heard him kill a watcher. Then, blasts from the Ravager's cannon. Silence. I tried opening the door, but he'd locked me in.
He saved your life, and I'll never be able to thank him.
No, that's true, but at least you're alive.
Do you have any idea where the machines came from, or why they attacked so suddenly?
We've been seeing more and more machines around here every year. That's why my father hired more guards. But they've never attacked like this before. I have no idea what caused it.
Okay, then I'll look around.
I'm gonna have a look around.
I will. I need to take a moment with my father.
Yeah, you do that. Just gonna also check the area you just came from, just in case there's anything here. Apparently not. And there's a staircase I can't access. So anything else? There's of course a lot of signs of battle in here, but
I need to get in there and look at that thing.
Unknown device. Emitting a certain frequency. Oh, that is the workshop, and I got the key for it as well. These guys all died very dramatic. I think I should be able to open the door then, I suppose. Or if I would have found the door. That's not the door. This is probably the door. Yeah, thank you. Why does the camera zoom out like that if we open the door? It doesn't really need to do that, I suppose, but entering, workshop key removed. And then someone placed this device here. luring the machines over here.
That device is sending out a signal. Could be what attracted the machines.
I suppose we should turn that off then.
Okay, that should cut the signal. But someone put this here to call in the machines and kill everyone on the estate.
Interesting. So that's emitting unidentified single frequency signal. But where did it come from? Can we check that out? Or do we just need to go talk to the girl again? Okay. Hello there.
I found a lure. I think someone might have put it here deliberately to draw in the machines. Did your father have enemies?
Reinemann. My brother.
Seriously?
First there was gambling, then stealing, then extortion. He swore vengeance when my father kicked him out.
It was Ronimon who begged me to come. He needed the machines cleared out to claim the property.
We can't let him. That murderous snake.
Ooh.
Can't let me do what, sister? Claim my inheritance?
We shared a crash, murderer. Have you no honor?
Oh, I guess not. But I will have this estate. When you meet father in the next life, tell him I'm enjoying his money.
He's still carrying the beacon.
As for you, this little device will summon more machines. A lot easier than killing you myself.
Oh, yeah, thought something like that was gonna happen. He's an idiot. So those are Glinthawks. I know how to deal with those. Fire arrows. That was hilarious. Need to take those out quickly. Ow. That's not what I was doing. Jesus Christ, these things are flying high. Ow. Okay, so heavy strikes when they're down seem to work. Just taking this one down with me. Ow! Get down, you monster! Yeah, bye. Okay, talk to Robbie. And a small machine core, I can sell that. Nope, that was not what I wanted to do, but that was really hilarious how those Glinthawks just picked the man up and tossed him away like garbage.
Probably needed the wash.
Let's go talk to the Roddy. Where is she? Over there, back at the estate, of course. Because that was, well, we've dealt with more than three Glinthawks at the same time already, so.
I'm glad there are good people like you in the world. It helps to make up for scum like my brother. My father was always generous in his gratitude. A family tradition I would like to continue. Take this. I hope it will help you in your travels.
Thank you, whatever it is. A remarkable reward box and 3,750 experience points. That is interesting, and I just became level 20. Okay, let's see. I only still have 2 skill points, and I want to have 3 at the least. So, nothing right there, but then we have the treasure box. Just a watcher lens. And that's it. I think that pretty much does it for this episode. I'd like to thank you all for... Oh, yeah, that's just level up rewards. I thought that was just... I just received another skill point, but that's not the case. So I'd like to thank you all enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And yeah, I'd hope to see you in the next episode. Goodbye.